hard like a Diddy party.
Ain't no party like a Diddy party. So we back. And what was supposed to be a session where we finish up a tournament, we gotta redo the whole fucking thing. Because I accidentally deleted the footage. So, we doing the second part of the 2000s bracket. Like I told y'all last time we recorded, Justin Timberlake won the first bracket. I know y'all had some strong feelings about that. But before we get into the feelings, y'all introduce yourselves or reintroduce yourselves to the people.
Shit, 601 Jimmy Ju.
First up, in the last bracket, y'all basically was like, this don't even really deserve to be in there. Do y'all stand by that?
I don't remember what it went against. Me neither.
But I'm saying, y'all said it shouldn't even been in here. You said the only reason it was in here is because of Chris Brown. Some of y'all said that.
Probably. If I should
die before I wake, that ain't a bad song, but...
That's going against this.
Did it go against his last time?
Mm-hmm. Oh. All the matchups gonna be the same. Oh. So I assume all y'all answers gonna be the same, but the people don't know what y'all pick. So you just gotta rock with it.
I think we both end up picking our ass.
Is that still y'all answer?
Yep.
Alright. Next up.
Yeah. You know it's funny. Seems every time
I damn near ain't gotta hear the next song. And I might have said that last time.
I think you did. And I'ma skip ahead for the people.
You know.
I'm not. I skip ahead. I just fucked that up. Now I'm gonna skip ahead for the people. There was somebody like who was heavy on my mind every time I heard this song, but now I can't remember who it is.
Woman? Female?
It wasn't no nigga.
I mean, I thought you was in reference to like a moment or like a...
Nah, like it was like an ex or whatever. But I can't remember who it is now.
It's that's some shit, though.
Yeah, no, that's definitely one of the ones. Let's go against this.
I think I voted for this Monica.
Yeah, you did, and I voted with the last song.
Is either one of y'all answers changing?
Nah, I'm voting for the first song.
I voted Marcus Houston on the last one, too, so... That's gonna stay the same. Next up. And I hate we gotta redo this whole thing because it takes some of the pizzazz out of it. But you gotta have content.
Like next track.
I think y'all both voted for that last song.
Voted for this, I thought.
Yeah.
This is a... I say this. I like this song because it's one of the few... Not one of the few, but it's like... It's women supporting their friends. by just being supportive, not supporting their friends by bashing a nigga. And I enjoy that.
Yeah. And I like the production on this too.
That's really
not the production. I fuck with the production. It's that guitar sound, like it should be in a Robin Thicke song, in my opinion. Next up. I feel like this was like mid late 2010s, right? I mean 2000s.
Yeah, it's like 08, 09.
Does this, I feel like this, the production on this song and somewhat what she doing captures women in that time. Like I think Jones had said something, or Matt might have said something about one of them songs was like, it if you was to put the early 2000s in a song, that would be it. I kind of feel like this is that for the late 2000s. Let's go against this. All right, so let's go in against this.
I went with that motherfucking J-Lo.
Is that because you secretly a Ja Rule fan?
It's just, if the early 2000s rap R&B combos, this will come to mind.
I agree.
Are you also agreeing with the vote?
Yeah.
I'm gonna keep it rolling. We'll be out of here in 45 minutes.
I highly doubt that.
Cause it was some songs that you ain't get to last time. So we gonna get to them. Just to think about it, I would do things that I would regret. Trying to get you to understand how I felt for you. I try.
Oh, we were split on this. Cause I took the NDIRE.
You did. And you took old Keisha. And then I said what I said about the other Keisha.
Yeah.
So much cunt. That was gonna get cut anyway.
Sometimes I did.
It was like that bump, like a door closing.
Like bump, bump, bump. All I wanna see, can you show me? Baby, turn around and let me see this. You better go bump, bump, bump. Just depends on whatever feels good in my
soul. Ooh, ooh, ooh. What y'all, y'all keep me y'all same votes?
All right. Of course. Keisha Cole.
Okay, so last time, I voted for Keisha as well. But I might change. Let me go back to this. I think hands down she get production. Just to think about it, I would do things that I think everything else. I think she got other songs that would be more crowd appeal than this song.
Yeah, I agree.
But fuck it. I'm gonna vote the indie. I'm finna change my vote. Next up.
I got eyes.
And I'm gonna say, like I said last time, shout out to ATF. Shout out to Big Booty Judy Party.
And I chose this. I'm choosing this.
What does this have over the other song? Cause it don't got crowd appeal. It might have production. Production might have something to say. But vocally, I don't think he touching him. Honestly, Mr. Big.
I feel like the subject matter of the song, and like, I mean, that Mr. Big song is like one of my favorite songs, like, period.
Right.
But like, I'm choosing this.
This is our feeling, essentially.
Not necessarily. It's the time, and I know this ain't a criteria, but like, when I hear this song, it takes me back to a specific time.
I was kind of finna go there. Like, I do think the Contagious got overall crowd appeal, but I think the people for a time period, this capture a time better than Contagious do.
I agree.
Contagious just universal, you know.
I can agree with that, but I mean,
like, I
if we talking, if we set the criteria, according to the criteria, which one is better?
I mean,
which one, you know, go through?
I mean, my choice.
Your body, your choice. Huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Happy Pride Month as well.
But one thing about Contagious, I feel like I hear Contagious every year. Like, in some setting, some shape, form, or fashion, I'm going to hear Contagious. I don't hear this that much, so it has more of a reminiscent factor, and it takes me back to a time where I was in love with R&B. Contagious is just one of them nigga karaoke songs. It's a good song, and it has crowd appeal, but
the skit play in a lot to Contagious. Yeah. Well, it's not necessarily a skit, but
the video.
Yeah.
That's true. But you hearing the song every year adds to the crowd appeal. That's because people want to hear it that much.
But it's it's an R&B bracket too.
It is. But let me get to my other point.
Oh.
If you heard this just as much as you heard Contagious, I don't think you would feel the same about it. Because you don't hear this as much, it's just like any other old song that you don't hear as much no more. When you hear it, it automatically take you back to that time. Heard this every year, or as much as often you hear Contagious, I think it would be about the same. Like, every time I hear this, I think about ATL. I don't hear this that often. I don't watch ATL that often. But that's one of my favorite movies. But your vote is your vote.
Oh yeah.
Next song. Shit.
This is one of the more ones right here. This is one of them ones. We need a nigga free yourself.
How would it go?
It wouldn't be baby, it'll be bitch. I know that. Say baby when you're trying to holler at a bitch.
Goddamn. Goddamn. I'm all over the place. I'm gonna say again, like I said last time, I used to hate this song. Let's go against this.
I got Fantasia.
Just get paid for myself on this one. Oh, okay. That's what y'all voted last time. Is he okay? In the realm of R&B. As an overall artist, baby, I just don't get it. Will he ever consider being a legend?
I know you smell the perfume. I don't know if he'll ever be a legend.
You don't believe his story. Who this?
Mario.
I know the.
Oh.
Wait, no. I knew the song. The artist.
No.
Will he ever be I think in the R&B circle, vocally, people will put him up there. But as far as his catalog, he might not. No. Like, he might be your favorite R&B artist. Some, not a lot. But I mean, vocally, like, he's shitting on a lot of niggas.
He is. But I think he's also somebody where you gotta know the catalog to know the vocals. So, if I don't know the catalog, how am I gonna put him up there vocally? But I think the one thing that separates a lot of them niggas out of the 2000s And even some of these niggas that we gonna cover when we get to the 2010s is longevity. He ain't got the longevity. Niggas know Usher from 90s to today. Niggas know R. Kelly from 90s to today. Maxwell, motherfucking, even go back some, like Prince from the 70s and 80s and all that shit. Like, these niggas span decades. He only had a couple years. It was a hell of a couple years. But
I thought he had a good 5 year run.
So the question is Omarion an R&B legend?
Nope. Not to me.
If you put B2K with it, I think you.
Nope. Even with B2K. In my opinion.
Yeah, I wouldn't call him a legend.
Cause he, I mean, he whooped my Omarion ass in that verses.
He definitely did.
Right, right, this was the episode you was on. Yes.
I don't think I watched that one.
Cause we talked about this on the Versus episode.
I ain't know they did one.
But people will agree that Omarion catalog is better. Or more popular.
Yeah.
More popular, yeah. But I mean, even he only had, like, once he left B2K, or they broke up or whatever happened, he only had like a couple years. He had that verse. The album O, and then 21, and then the shit with him and Bow Wow. But
this shit jam.
It is. That's why I kept this conversation going, so I could hear it. I'm waiting on him to hit these high notes at the end. Not these high notes. It's some other high notes.
Waiting for a nigga to scream is crazy.
You know, I'm willing to wait for the desired results. Here we go. If it'll play.
I'm gonna ask the group, I'm gonna see what they think.
You finna get no valid opinions out of there.
Huh? I just wanna hear what other people think. I'm gonna say rapper or R&B artist and see what they think.
Watch that. You gonna get some more of that?
Nah, you can kill it.
I wasted half my cup. So what y'all?
It's hard for me to go against this. Song for song, I would go this. But if it's an R&B battle.
What was the first? Mario.
Let me love you.
Oh, Mario.
Yeah, Mario.
Mario.
Yeah.
Ain't gotta change none on that thing. Next up. That was another song I ain't like either, cause I'm not a hood nigga.
It's that 4 minutes.
But this a nigga that they would never go for in real life.
I ain't gotta hear the next song.
This was one of the ones I think you changed your mind on. Is this that one? This is that one. It might not be that one.
I don't remember.
If you play the next song, I think it is. But I think it's next is next.
What you think next? I'm talking fast, stumbling all over my words. I heard you were leaving town. I thought I'd be the one to know first. If you have a minute, let me talk to you and see what's going on. Seven.
Don't say it's
nothing. Oh. There's gotta be something that's going wrong. Now let me explain, but I don't know what to say, cause I don't know what the hell happened. I come in the house. This is another song I didn't like, cause I feel like 4 minutes ain't enough time. Let's go in against this. This is my vote going as well. This nigga had some shit, bro. That first album he had, I had that bitch on CD. That motherfucker got some shit on it.
I forgot who this was. Who this is?
It's Mario.
Showing the fuck is
he was walking around some cold ass city. I don't know where he from. Wearing
Baltimore
fur coats and shit. It looked like Baltimore too. It's all run down and shit.
It probably just an East Coast jazz. But now
I see. I mean, it's always cloudy in that bitch.
Just like I feel like Milwaukee is a Midwest version of jazz.
I ain't never been either one, so I don't
shit.
Know.
Shit, compared to some of these bitches that be coming out here from now.
It's two that, well, one used to work with me. I don't know if she still gonna be there.
It's a close one.
Milwaukee definitely got some shit now. That's why it's women.
You know what? If it was any other Avant song, I would choose Avant.
If it was Read Your Mind, you would pick that up with this.
Oh yeah.
Hell
yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
My First Love.
Yeah, for me.
Phone Sex.
I don't know about that. Don't Take Your Love Away. That'll be a debate. I'm going to Mario though.
Me too.
Sweet.
But if it was any other Avant song.
Yeah. The Avant a motherfucker, bro.
It would've won.
Well, you know.
I wish I could shuffle the shit up, but it, you know, it wouldn't let me.
Justin Timberlake?
Mm-mm. Oh nah,
this Bobby.
Mm-hmm. Why it sound like
Ain't nobody can take you away from my love.
It sound like a
My Love.
It sound like a Justin Timberlake.
It sound like My Love, the way My Love
Timberland beat.
Yep.
They all sound the same to me. Timberland, people give Timberland all this credit for being this super producer, but a lot of his shit sound the same. Foundationally, they all sound the same.
Sometimes they will make a good producer.
I mean, that's true. Dr. Dre did it. All his shit sound the same. Let me phrase. All his shit don't sound the same. All his shit is the same concept.
Yeah.
Take a song, throw some bass on that bitch. But then once he got to like Eminem and 50 Cent, that's when he really kind of started producing.
Yeah.
In my opinion. All right, cool. Let's go against this.
Oh, this win by default. They don't make
Why them, win by default?
They don't make them like this no more. Last time you heard a song about a woman catering to a man.
I feel like I have.
I'm trying to think of one.
Me too. But I feel like I got one, but I can't. It's not coming to me. Promise by Sierra. Kind of. It ain't catering, but it's.
It's been a same. Long. That was in this decade.
Yeah, well, but dang, it's further ahead in this decade.
Boy, this one times was a lot better.
Let me run your bath water. Nah, motherfucker won't even cut the shower on for you.
Damn, I'm trying to think.
Damn, bro, this shit ugly.
I can't think. But y'all both on for this?
Yeah. Well, I can't speak for Tom.
Okay. Well, I ain't got. I'm just.
Michelle going spoke shit the that gospel on this though.
Definitely. Next up. I think this was one that y'all was like, "Oh, this shit gonna win anyway." And then when I played the next song, y'all was like, "Hold up." Y'all was like, "Hold up."
Dun-dun-dun.
This one we was talking about. You said eating ass and shit.
This song.
I don't remember feeling like this.
Cause I had brought up the baby song Nasty.
Oh,
and
yeah.
He was like, he talking about eating ass. They say you crashed out. I put up the clip where you was talking about the Yin Yang Twins video.
Yeah.
Nigga said you was confessing the whole video.
Oh, that's the video. What I say? Where I used to beat my meat to that?
Yeah.
Shit.
They say, oh nah, that nigga crashed.
She still with Nelly. Mm-hmm. They got to split in their first child, I think. He's like the lighter to my cigarette. Together.
Take off the list. So let's go against this.
This is one of the ones, too.
Yeah.
Wayne Wonder, baby. Dirty wine and
I'm gonna
shit.
Say this. So like I remember this song from the like from that time, but it had to be maybe at least once in like the once a year for like the past maybe 4 years, I would hear it and be like, damn, I need to download that bitch because it that nostalgia kicked in.
Mm-hmm.
But I would always forget. But I finally did it. I finally like went on and downloaded like last year. Like this shit jamming.
I go to the Shanty though.
So y'all switching y'all vote?
Now that I think about it, I'm gonna go with Shanty.
Okay. First switch by y'all, and I definitely don't agree, but whatever. Next up, another song by a rapper.
Yo, this hard. This another nigga. When he rapped, he rapped.
But how often did he get melodic? Besides this,
let me think.
and his country shit.
That, no, yeah. Because Air Force Ones is not melodic.
Grills is not melodic.
Yeah. EI is not melodic.
None of that shit.
Pimp Juice, could you?
No, it ain't.
It's just a hook, really.
That shit ain't melodic. Motherfucking
Sweat Suit. What's the one he said? My Place was melodic.
I'm talking about what's the one? Down, down, baby. That shit.
Oh no, nah, that's rapping. That, Country Grammar is Country Grammar. Rapping. Yeah, yeah, it's one of the best songs of all time to me. Well, most unique. Like, it's nothing like it.
Okay.
This shit hard though.
No, Country Grammar or Pop Lock and Drop It.
Country Grammar.
Or Rocky Hips.
Country Grammar.
I might take Rocky Hips.
This one of them.
Mainly for old girl verse.
Cause this is what we were talking about, what if Fred O'Bain got on some shit like this. And
yeah, let's go against this. Y'all was talking about Soul Plane.
Oh yeah. Well, oh boy. It's Pride
that's a
Month.
That's a terrible fucking movie, but it's a classic though.
I'm going you know what,
and
I'm
you
going.
Gotta tell him no.
Nelly and Kelly. Ain't no dilemma.
Retweet.
Alright. Cause I don't wanna hear that shit no way.
While you on some fucking vibe.
A lot of Destiny's Child shit gonna get on down. So cater to you.
Let me see. Did y'all vote? What did y'all vote? Oh, okay. That's going against this.
Mario. Oh, hold on.
It might just be the color of the lights hitting this. But this looked like if they had like a rosé whiskey in these lights.
Definitely the light.
What y'all voting for?
I'm gonna go,
this is a little tough.
I'm gonna go Melon and Fiona.
This nigga disrespected the fuck out of me talking about I did a damn. Never mind.
I'm going this.
Damn.
Listen.
So, I don't remember who voted what.
R&B was better back when niggas was simping.
I don't remember who. I don't know who voted what. But the last time, It Kills Me won.
Yeah.
I switched my vote.
You saying you switching it now?
No, no, no. I'm saying
last time, yo.
Last time I chose, and It Kills Me.
And then you switched it.
Yes.
So you switching it now? I'm saying so.
Yeah, last yeah, time, yeah. My pick is.
Is it,
How Do I Breathe?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let me go back. And I remember you saying James is a sucker for intros. I feel like this intro is better than Mario intro.
I feel like the production overall, because it didn't sound like nothing else at the time. That Mario beat kind of generic. All
right. I think I'm gonna go with this and just keep it the same. Next two.
And now, folks, it's time to say goodnight. We sincerely appreciate your patronage and hope we've succeeded in bringing you an enjoyable evening of entertainment. Please drive home carefully and come back again soon. Good night.